If you're someone who's played online games before, you have probably encountered a loading screen. The goal of loading screens is to display a distraction to the user while the computer is loading assets behind the scenes. Using the unityengine.scenemanagement namespace, we can create all kinds of scene transitions for a game. For this tutorial, we will be creating a scene manager script which will contain all of our scene-related code. The functions of this script can be executed using keyboard buttons. Of course, we will put this script into a game object that can exist in between scenes. As you can see, I've already set up scene 1 and scene 2. This is what scene 1 looks like. And this is what scene 2 looks like. First, let's create an empty game object and rename it to Scene Manager. Then, let's create a script named Scene Manager Script and open it in our code editor. We need to make sure that only one instance of our object exists, so let's first create an awake function, then an if condition. This line of code just means that if this same exact object already exists in another instance, we are going to destroy this game object. Then we will use return to end the code there. However, if both of these conditions are not met and there are no other instances of this object, we will use this object as our only instance. Outside of the if statement, we will use the don'tDestroyOnLoad method so that a scene manager object doesn't self-destruct when entering different scenes. Now, let's actually write some scene loading. I'm going to make another function that will load the next and previous scene. This is actually very simple to do. Let's put the using unityengine.scenemanagement namespace on top. The getActiveScene.buildIndex part gets the index of the current scene, and then adding 1 will allow us to get the index of the next scene. We should also make sure that the next scene does exist before we try loading it. So let's add an if statement to check if the next scene exists. Then, let's make a different function to load the previous scene by copying the next function and changing the plus signs to minus. Now that our load functions are complete, let's go to our update function to execute them through buttons N and B. Let's also include a debug.log function so that we can see if it works in the console. Now we can copy this if statement and change all the nexts to backs. Let's go back to Unity and see all this code in action. Don't forget to drag your scenes into the buildIndex settings in the top left. Here is our scene 1, and now if we press N, the next scene should load. In our console, we should also see the word next. We can also see that the scene manager is still in our hierarchy window. Now if we press B, we should go back to scene 1. Let's discuss the differences between buildIndex, sceneCount and sceneCountInBuildSettings. I added a function called checkScene which will print out these three properties onto a console. Let's use the button C to execute this function in update. Now let's see what happens if we press play. And then C. Firstly, our buildIndex prints out 0. This is because scene 1 is the first scene we put in our build settings. Next, our scene count is 1, and our scene count in build settings is 2. Why? There is only one scene count, because there is currently only one loaded scene in the game. And there are two scene counts and build settings, because there are two scenes in our game. To conclude, the build index refers to the order of the scene in the build index. The scene count is the total number of currently loaded scenes, and the scene count in build settings is the total number of scenes in build settings. There are two modes of scene loading, single and additive. These two are performed through load scene mode. To code the additive mode, we just need to add comma, load scene mode dot additive. So far, we've only been using the single mode of loading, so let's actually compare the two side by side. As you can see, single mode loads the scene as a single scene, while additive mode makes the scene overlap with the already active scene. Additive mode loading can be used for game systems shared across all scenes, for displaying UI, for loading and unloading chunks of a wide landscape, and for creating different mission levels. Two more ways of scene loading are synchronous, also known as blocking, and asynchronous, also known as non-blocking. In synchronous loading, the current scene blocks or freezes until the next scene is loaded. This is where loading screens come into place. Loading screens use asynchronous loading, which allows the next scene to load in the background first and then be displayed after. In our Unity editor, I set up a loading screen with a simple animation so that we can compare the difference between the two. Let's go back to a code editor and code asynchronous loading. We are going to start by creating a coroutine. SceneManager.loadSceneAsynch is the method we are going to use. However, since we need to constantly be loading a scene, we need to use a while loop. Let's contain this method in an asynchronous operation that I will call OP. While the operation is not done yet, yield return null. This will make sure that our operation keeps working until the job is done. I'm going to execute this inside our next scene function. Don't forget to use the using systems.collections namespace. Now let's sit back and compare the two side by side. We can observe that as we load into scene 2, the loading screen freezes in synchronous, while the loading screen runs smoothly in asynchronous. Thanks for watching this video. If you learned something new, support the channel by subscribing. Let me know if you have any questions. Take care and see you soon.